You might be surprised to hear that after phase two, when your battery is placed, we don't turn on your device for another 3 to 4 weeks.
Why do we wait? We wait because after brain surgery, some patients go through a honeymoon period, which we call a microlessioning effect. This is when the symptoms temporarily decrease or even go away without even turning on the stimulator, just by merely placing the lead.
We wait to make sure your symptoms have completely returned, so we have symptoms to look at when we adjust your stimulation.
After these 3 or 4 weeks, we have you come back for your first programming and a CT scan.
The programming appointment is where we find the level of stimulation that best improves your symptoms. The appointment takes about 2 hours.
If you're on Parkinson's medication, we'll have you come to the appointment without taking those medications. While this is uncomfortable, we need to see your symptoms in clinic.
Bring your medication with you because, as with off and on testing during the workup, we will have you take them halfway through your programming appointment.
At this visit, the provider will test each contact on the lead to determine which program setting will give you the best benefit with the least side effects. We'll also increase the stimulation to see how you respond. When we do this, you may have side effects such as numbness, tingling, or muscle pulling. This is normal, and again, it's temporary. It helps us to determine what settings are the best for you.
After programming, it takes some time for the brain to adjust. This means you'll need to come back to have the settings fine-tuned.
You might notice some symptoms like tremor may be relieved right away, while others, like dystonia, may take more time.
You may feel some side effects from stimulation such as speech changes, visual changes, numbness and or tingling, and muscle tightness of the face and arm. These usually stop after stimulation stops or gets adjusted. Always contact your DBS neurology nurse with any questions or concerns.
You'll want to limit your physical activity until you are cleared by the neurosurgeon.
Don't lift, push, or pull anything heavier than 8 to 10 pounds. A gallon of milk, for instance, is about 8 pounds.
Don't fly in an airplane for at least 3 weeks. Don't drive until you're able to fully turn your neck, or you're off any narcotic medication, or until your surgeon says it's okay.
If you have a job, you can discuss when to return to work with your neurosurgeon. You may return to taking medications for Parkinson's, tremor, or dystonia following both surgeries.
Your incisions will be covered with surgical glue. You can get them wet, but do not soak them in bath, pool, or hot tub for at least 1 month following surgery.
Your incisions may be covered with a dressing instead of glue. You can usually take the dressing off 2 days after surgery and get the incisions wet 3 days after surgery.
If they itch, do not scratch them. Gently rub outside of the incision only. Otherwise, you may cause an infection.
You'll have an appointment in the neurosurgery clinic 2 weeks after phase two battery placement to check how well your incisions are healing.
That's generally what you can expect after your DBS surgery. Our next video will cover what your responsibilities are for self-care.